Gumke, and I'm kind of related to this guy.
This is my daughter, or I'm her dad, depending on how you look at it. I'm the drum instructor for the Lancers, and the two of us are going to try to entertain you this evening. But, so we don't talk too much, we're going to all bring out the Lancers, and Billy Moe is going to drum them in, and we're going to play the national anthem. When they're in, I'll ask you to all rise, please, out of respect to our country.
You.
Music.
Very good. to listen to me make a couple of announcements that we think are very important. First of all, from the Lancers, thanks to the Pullo Center and the Pullo staff, this is a wonderful place to perform, and we're just always honored to come here and to bring Brother Bugle Corps to Penn State. So thank you, Pullo Center. Also, there are a lot of thanks. You can wait till the end. Also, thank you to Mission Barbecue, which is a local restaurant which services, pays for men and women in the military, people in the police, first responders. They have donated money to pay for the dinner for the Marines this evening. And so we want to thank you. Get out to the northwest end of town, stop at Mission Barbecue. The food is very good. When I told the Marines that's where the food was coming from, they were delighted.
I personally like the brisket.
Also, in the program, which I want you to look at carefully, please, there are sponsors and advertisers. Please recognize them, and if you're out in the community and you can support those people, we would really appreciate that. Additionally, Lancers will perform in a show called Thunder on the Hill in Milton on the 22nd of July. Corps there will include the Skyliners, the Cavs, the Bucks, Blessed Sac, and the Lancers. The Lancers will also be playing at a music festival in Gettysburg in June, so please support the Lancers, come to see us. If you're interested, tickets at Thunder on the Hill, $25, they're on sale now. You can go online at Eventbrite and support them.
Is that all? Can I clap now?
You can
clap. That's all the things.
I missed one, and this is important.
I apologize.
I want to thank Scott Rowland, who in Hanover provides rehearsal space for the Lancers Guard at no cost. And finally, I want to say thank you to everyone who's here tonight, braving the weather, braving the elements, coming out to support the Lancers. So now I'm done, and now, can we
clap? All right. All right, well, are we about to get this show started?
We are.
All right, well, I don't know how this is gonna work with the curtain, because Dad and I are on the wrong side, now we're supposed to be over there. So just, you know, we're gonna slowly mosey over this way. I'm gonna talk while I walk. Yeah, there you go. All right, well, our first musical group that's up is a local, wonderful young group of folks. And as my dad just mentioned to me, the Lancers really like to promote local young groups of musicians, and this is one of them. So this is the Dallastown JV Drumline. And, oh, that's a good one, Blaze. And I had a chance to just talk with Katie, Kenzie, Ava, and Blaze. And I learned some really interesting facts about them. So their instructor is actually part of the Lancers. His name is Zane Ruth, correct? And before I forget, Zane Ruth's wife's birthday is today. Happy birthday. Anyway, this group is really cool because Zane allows young people to come and join even if they've never played a percussion instrument. So there are folks that are in this group who literally have just started, and then there are older individuals who have been playing for many years of their lives. These are 7th, 8th, and 9th graders, and they're going to entertain us, and we are very excited to have them. Anything else, Dan?
Yes, and watch for Zane. He's the tippinest with the Lancers. A marvelous, marvelous percussionist, and we're glad to have him. And I know that the groups in York are glad to have Zane for teaching. Yeah, really wonderful instructor.
Awesome. So, ladies and gentlemen, Dallastown JV Drumline.
Thank you.
and I use the word advisable, drummer. When I look at a group like this and realize those people are just learning to play, you look at their hands, they had such a similarity of style. So such good instruction from Zane. Also looked at the little move they did where they dropped down behind the trash cans. Tried that one year with the Lancers, we needed three chiropractors. So, I don't know what happened to my assistant. She's out gathering information, but soon we're gonna see the Blessed Sacrament Corps. Some years ago, I stood here and I talked about how drum corps after World War I and World War II was basically supported by American Legion posts and VFWs. And then in the period after that, in the 50s, 60s, the Catholic Church really stepped forward and supported drum corps, especially in New England, New Jersey, and Maryland. And Blessed Sacrament was a junior corps. They started out as a wonderful corps. They won many national championships. I would ask you to read in the program all the championships that they won. And the thing I remember about North Jersey and Blessed Sacrament, I went up there to judge a couple times. And I went up and when you went to an area where they didn't know who you were, they really would question your credentials. And so I would stand there and I would get a lot of grief because somebody was not happy with the scores I gave them. And if you judge drum corps, it was really interesting because if there were six corps, and I can't hold up six fingers, if there were six corps, all six corps are angry with you. Five were angry because they didn't win, and the sixth was angry because they didn't you didn't give them enough points and they didn't win by enough. So, Paul, what do you got? I'm out of material.
Okay. Let me try to fill some time.
All right.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Well, I just had a chance to meet the lovely ladies from the Color Guard here, and they told me that they started in the 70s as teenagers, and they were all friends then. They started in the junior corps, and they're still marching today. That's pretty, pretty awesome. So I'm really excited to see what they're going to do. It's going to be great. I also understand that many of the folks here, well, not many, but they sort of started dating over time, and there are actually some married members of the corps because they met as part of you know, rehearsing together. So how cool is that? And there's a group of people here who travel from Massachusetts to New Jersey to rehearse with them. They have some individuals who drive 5 hours to come to practice. They practice once a month, I think, is what I heard. And one of the gentlemen here used to play for the Riley Raiders.
We have some old Riley Raiders in the audience, I'm sure. One of the things that I want to point out about this corps, when I read their goals and the reason for their existence, they said to promote friendship and camaraderie. And for people who've been doing drum corps for a long time, the most important thing you can do is promote friendship, because there are friends in this corps, as Holly was suggesting, that go back to the 70s. And there are friends in drum corps that are friends with other corps. So I think that's a wonderful goal. A nice mission statement, if you will. So we're going to turn this over to Blessed Sac. Thank you, sir.
Ready? Cut!
time to break some new ground this evening. We're going to introduce a drum corps by talking about Fred Waring and his Pennsylvanians. I wish the lights were up because I bet there are only three people in this audience who remember Fred Waring and the Pennsylvanians. Back in 1918, Fred Waring was a student at Penn State University. You didn't know this, did you?
I didn't know this.
And he started a band. And one of the things about the band that was famous was he had them sing. So they sang and they played. They were very famous on radio. And then in the 50s, they finally made the change, morphed over to television. That was in the days when the TV set was about this big in black and white. And so here's the tie-in with the group that's here. When I watched a show, Fred Waring, he had on the show a drum corps from Tyrone, Pennsylvania called the Garden March. And they were marching on this little screen, but there they were, the Gardner Guards. And I knew people who played in that corps. And the corps you see here today traces its lineage back to the Tyrone Gardner Guards, and we can tie that back to Fred Waring and to Penn State, and here we are, Penn State. And isn't that just a nice little story? You'll never hear that story again.
So I was talking to Connor up here. This is Connor Hummel. He is their drum major. I was talking to Tim Longwell, wherever he is, way back in the back there. And they were telling me this really cool story about Keystone Regiment and the fact that it had started in around 1985, when we started before that. But they used to march in an amusement park. They were the amusement park drum and bugle corps in a place called Boyertown, USA. How interesting is that? So anytime they wanted to play, they were like, hey, let's go get on the roller coaster and then we'll march around. So anyway, we're super excited to have them here. Between the Gardner Guards and the Cambria Cadets, they came together. We're super excited to have them here. Connor, we're gonna let you take it away. Ladies and gentlemen, Keystone Regiment.
Thank you. Thank you.
tell you that this amazing group behind us is going to blow your mind. Before we do that, and I don't know if we can have just a little bit of house lights, I'd just like to ask if there are any veterans in the audience, if you would stand to be recognized.
Woo!
I have goosebumps on my goosebumps. I have never heard anything so beautiful, and I am so excited to share this with you. Tonight, we have under the direction of Officer in Charge, Chief Warrant Officer Courtney Lawrence, who I might add is getting promoted to Captain on April 4th. They're here from Marine Barracks in Washington, D.C., and I had a chance to talk to several of them, and some of them actually came up through DCI, through Drum Corps, and I'm sure maybe more than I even met, but that's pretty cool. So I am not going to belabor this. I'm going to turn this over to Sergeant Alex Liddell, who is the expert here, and you are all going to be amazed. Ladies and gentlemen, the U.S. Marine Drum and Bugle Corps.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Marine Barracks, Washington, D.C. proudly presents the Commandant's Own United States Marine Drum and Bugle Corps. Formed in 1934, the Commandant's Own celebrates 88 years of marching and musical excellence while carrying the distinction of being the only active duty drum and bugle corps currently serving in the United States Armed Forces. Today's concert opens with a march by John Philip Sousa, borrowing its name from the Marine Corps' sacred motto, Semper Fidelis. Please welcome to the stage the Director and Executive Officer of the Commandant's Own, Chief Warrant Officer 2, Courtney Lawrence.
Thank you.
featuring baritone soloist Sergeant Froilan Barbosa, soprano soloist Staff Sergeant Benjamin Aird, and mellophone soloist Staff Sergeant Christopher Walker.
Thank you.
center stage as the unit presents a unique blend of Latin jazz standards made famous by artists Johnny Richards and Arturo Sandoval, Quien Sabe and La Virgen de la Macarena, featuring soprano soloists Lance Corporal Lane Myers, Corporal Michael Rosy, and Master Sergeant Randy Rivera. Stars and Stripes Forever.
privilege to introduce to you the Hawthorne Caballeros. And though they are fan favorites, I was going to do this sort of fun joke about hold on to your hats because it was so windy, and then hold on to your shakos for the other drum corps members, and then hold on to your sombreros because they're going to blow us away. But unfortunately, they have had two of their members recently pass away, and one of them was their business manager. So I'm going to turn this over to their current business manager, Chris Sortino, and they're going to do a special program for you. Thank you so much. Enjoy the Hawthorne Caballeros.
Sortino. I am the new director of the Alumni Corps due to the passing of Paul Bon Jovi, who was the director here for some 10 years. And he died suddenly just last month. And it hit us quite hard. And we're just trying to get going again emotionally. And we're going to dedicate this show and every show this year in Paul Bon Jovi's honor. So, I hope you enjoy everything that we do this evening. And but I must have to say one thing. Our new assistant director, Mr. Tyler Laval. He doesn't know I'm going to say this, but we have one of the members of the Corps who played in this Corps back in the 50s and the 60s, an incredible soloist, and he's on a lot of your albums that you've been listening to, Mr. Mike DelVecchio, who just turned 90 yesterday.
Thank you. Thank you.
much fun and so much energy.
They do. Definitely a good time. I was kind of moving. It was fun.
If I was introducing them tonight, and I didn't because we took a little different route because of the passing of the business manager, I was going to quote Robert Frost, who said, "Some say the world will end in fire, others say ice." And I think both those terms apply to the Cavs. There's a lot of fire, but they're so cool that there's really some ice there as well. So. But we should not be talking about the Cavs because they're gone. We should be talking about the Crusaders who are here. First, Holly was trying to say, can you park your car?
In Harvard Yard.
When it came out.
Well, in Boston, they say, park your car. In Harvard Yard.
Okay, and that's it for the Crusaders.
Okay, that's right. They told me I could say it. I'm sorry, it was terrible.
So, the Crusaders have a long history. They, like other cores that I've talked about, trace their heritage back to the Catholic Church. They were once the most precious blood Crusaders. I kind of think about that, and I'm glad that name is gone. Can you imagine going to the DCI show and saying, in first place, and then you've got to go through that one. So they've had a very complex history. They became eventually the Boston Crusaders. And I made the mistake of calling them the Boston Crusaders Alumni Corps, which they are not. They are really the Crusaders Senior Corps and started in 1991. And I would just like to say that in the audience, I have a friend, a drum corps friend, who was marching in the guard with them in the 50s, ended up being their corps director, and she now runs the show in Plymouth. So, Barb DeRusso, here's a shout out to you, a very famous lady who runs a wonderful, wonderful event in Plymouth.
They are the only alumni corps that has an active world-class corps in DCI today. The Boston Crusaders, I understand, finished second last year, so that's pretty cool that they have this affiliation with them. I also met several of the members backstage, really gracious, very kind, grateful to be here, we appreciate that. And they range in age from their 30s all the way up until their 80s. And I also learned an interesting fact, Dad. They are very nice to their rookies. They take them under their wing, they feel like family, but then the gentleman told me they get the full treatment. So I don't really know what the full treatment is, but if you see them outside of here, you may want to ask.
So the first appearance at Pullo, the Boston Crusaders. We hope they come back. Gentlemen, stage is yours.
Crusaders.
Thank you. can give you one more.
Thank you.
This will do better, won't it? So, couple of comments. One, in the program, there is a mistake. PIM next year is the 20th of April. It says that at one point, but there's a contradictory date somewhere else. 20th of April, get your tickets now. We're going to sell out. Couple of things. I have to tell you about some of my drummers. I tried to think of a good word for drummers in the Lancers, and that word is obsessed. I talked to one of my drummers, and he said he woke up at 1:30 in the morning, couldn't go to sleep, so he went downstairs, and he drummed till 4:30 in the morning. It's a little crazy. I have drummers who drive 3 hours one way to come to a two-hour practice. That's a little crazy. They're obsessed. I have drummers who said they drum so much, they have to put Band-Aids on their fingers. They're obsessed. So that's a key word. Another word that describes the Lancers is enthusiasm. And some of you know our horn instructor, one of our horn instructors, Brian Mal, does some of our arranging and is the chief horn instructor. Tuesday night we were rehearsing here, and Brian is trying to stomp out the time with his foot and direct with his hands, and somehow he put a fracture in his heel. So, trooper that he is, Brian stood on one foot, held his horn up, and he said, the show must go on. And so, Brian's here tonight. The show must go on. We'll make a couple of other comments. We saw the Marine Drum Corps. You saw what a magnificent, magnificent drum corps that is, and how, what an opportunity to be proud of our country and proud of our military. And in the Lancers, we have... That is the most well-deserved applause of the evening. In the Lancers, we have three former members of the Marine Drum Corps, which is one of the reasons we're as good as we are. And humility is not running it off. So when you heard our mini corps play the national anthem, the soloist who played the lead in the Star Spangled Banner was Sean Alt, former Marine Drum Corps. We also have two snare drummers from the Marine Drum Corps, Kirk McClain and Kevin Boyce. So it's really important to know the quality of musicians that we have in our corps, and they come from many places. So I'll be quiet, Hal, and you might have something to say.
Now I get to make something up, because that's going to be hard to follow.
Hard to follow.
I was just going to add that maybe the drummers are practicing so much because you scare them. Because, you know, my dad is the drum instructor, and he's so good. He's really good. I don't know if you know, he's in the Drum Corps Hall of Fame. Ever since I can remember, writing out little notes on music staffs with all of these paradiddles and things that I don't know about. But when you see this drum line, you're going to be blown away. I mean,
well, that remains to be seen.
Pretty impressive.
I don't know if you can see my hand, right? But my drummers laugh at this because I put up my hand and this finger...
Wait, he's putting up his index.
This finger, not the pen. And his finger kind of goes that way, and the other finger goes that way, and I think it's from all those years of holding the sticks and curling my fingers around, and when I hold up a finger, they all laugh. So they're not afraid of me.
Okay.
They're not afraid.
Got it. Okay, whatever you say. I want to give a shout out to the ladies. There's a lovely group of ladies down here in the front. They're teens recently and are doing a fantastic job. I also want to give a shout out to some of my ladies from the 70s who have now joined the Honor Guard over here. And all the other folks who are over there carrying our American flag and all of the others, we thank you so much for that. About 3 years ago, I think we were going to celebrate the 100th anniversary of the Lancers. So if I did my math right, this is the 103rd year that the Lancers have been in existence. Dad's been here the whole time.
Some of the drummers claim that's true. Okay, I think we have to get off before I become embarrassed.
We're just killing time. We're hoping that behind us there's some
takes a long time to get
them
on the stage. So.
Yeah.
I would just like to turn this over now to our assistant horn instructor and core director, drum major, Kristen Gould. I listened to everything from Rimsky-Korsakov to Neil Diamond. I can do Rimsky-Korsakov, but I can't say Diamond. So here we go. Diamonds Interrupt the Lancers.
All right, and if you want to join the Lancers, it's in your program. Check it out. Yep. Or Google them. They would love to have you join.
We always need members.
And thank you all for coming, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. a good night?
Yeah.